Good evening. Welcome to Greenville University, and you are at the first event of our homecoming weekend. Glad to have you with us. Now, we decided to start homecoming with jazz, but I would ask that if you have a phone that tends to play jazz when somebody phones you, would you just take a moment to make sure that your phones are on silence? That tends to break into the jazz concert. This evening, we're pleased to acknowledge and thank Midland States Bank as a premier sponsor throughout homecoming weekend. We appreciate their service and the convenient ATM available right here on campus. Weston Company is our jazz band concert sponsor this evening, and we thank this local accounting firm for their partnership with Greenville University. Would you join me in giving our sponsors a round of applause to show appreciation? Before we get started, would you bow your heads in prayer as we offer a word to our Lord? Heavenly Father, we're grateful this evening for the gift of music, for the artistic sensibilities that you give to each of us, for the fact that we are created in your image, and you have made us a creative person and people. We pray, O Lord, that all that is done this evening would redound to your glory. We pray for each musician. We pray that as they play tonight, they would play as unto you. In Christ's name we pray, amen. All right, let's join together in welcoming our jazz band under the direction of Will Fairbanks.
Good evening and welcome to homecoming. We're excited that you are here. Now, this is a special night. I need to make sure, did everybody get programs? You need to have at least one program per group because we're going to have a competition. There is a contest, and you have to have one of these to participate. And you want to because we have some great prizes at the end. And no, they're not paper clips. Some of you know what I'm talking about. All right, so what's going to happen? If you look at your program, this is not the order we're playing them in. If you notice, it's alphabetical. So you can find the tunes easier. Now, I will give you a couple of clues, and then we're going to play the chart. Your job is to figure out which song we're playing. If you figure it out, hold on to it. I will let you know when we get back after the song. If you got it right, put 10. You get 10 points by each song. Mark which ones you have. Trust me, the more you mark, the better your chances get by the end there. It's the honor system. So if you get it right, we're going to see how many. And there's a couple of songs on the back. So those of you who knew, last year we graduated about two-thirds of the band. So I'm really pleased that we have a page and a half, or a page and an eighth, or whatever it is, of music that we're going to share with you tonight, depending on how it's going. So you mark it, and at the end, we'll have people tell us their points, and we'll give out prizes. So are you ready to play? All right, so the first song, the hints, the clues are for the first song. The whole song we just played is based on the chord changes for Duke Ellington's It Don't Mean a Thing. So look over your list. It's based on the chord changes to It Don't Mean a Thing by Duke Ellington. All right, so you've looked over all those. All right, the correct answer is Swing Thing. So if you got that, put 10 points right there. So easy game, right? It's an easy game. Here's the clues for the next song we're about to play. It was written in 1930. Here are just a few of the artists that have performed this song. Louis Armstrong, Dave Brubeck, Benny Goodman, Lionel Hampton, Dizzy Gillespie, Count Basie, Lester Young, Billie Holiday, Bing Crosby, Ella Fitzgerald, Judy Garland, Doris Day, Frankie Lane, Nat King Cole, the Pied Pipers, Frank Sinatra, Willie Nelson, but the most famous one that went highest on the charts is Tommy Dorsey. And the song and the song is On the Sunny Side of the Street. Put yourself down 10 points if you got that. We had a soloist on trumpet, Cole. All right, how many have points so far? Any points? Good, good, we're doing well. All right, the next one, written in 1934. First recorded in England, and actually didn't come over to the United States until 1941. A portion of this song can be heard in the movie Casablanca. And tonight, we're going to feature our new vocalist, Ashley Hurley. So welcome her, please, to the mic. And the title of that tune? Now, I hope everyone got 10 points on that one. See, it's an easy game. I told you it was an easy game. And we featured again Ashley Hurley on vocals. Now, those of you who have been to a lot of our concerts, as you look through that concert playlist, you should not see anything that we have played before. That's another amazing thing. We put together an all-new playlist for you so you can hear some more standards plus some new tunes. So the next piece was written in 1936. The tidbit for that is in 2012, Barack Obama, in the East Room of the White House, joined with Buddy Guy and B.B. King singing the first verse of this song. Everybody's going, does Barack Obama sing? But yes, 2012 with B.B. King and Buddy Guy sang this tune. So for soloists, we had Will on bass trombone. His brother Wes on alto. And over on guitar, Ethan. And for 10 points, the name of that song? Sweet Home Chicago. Any guesses as to why Obama might have been sitting? No, I'm just kidding. All right, the next tune, written in 2019. Good luck. So I have one clue before we start. Are we almost ready? You ready to take that? All right, be careful. It's a riddle. Be careful, or you might find yourself barking up the wrong tree on this one. We'll be right back. On bass, Nathan. On trumpet, Cole. On piano, Garen. And the name of that tune? No, I'm kidding. Yes, that's right. Bad Dog. All right. Next to how many of you doing well? Anybody have 30 points yet? Good, good. I want everybody to be a winner. These are great prizes. You did too? Awesome. All right, the next piece, written 1941 by a trombone player. That narrows it down, right? The name of the song, refers to a street in New Orleans. 1941, written by a trombone player. The song title refers to a street in New Orleans. On tenor sax, Luke. On Barry, Danielle. All right, title? Perdido, exactly. Another 10 points for those who got it. Don't cheat, don't add. Next tune, 1932. First recorded by Tommy Dorsey. Carol Bruce sang the song in the 1941 comedy Keep 'Em Flying, starring Abbott and Costello. So 1932, written, first recorded, Tommy Dorsey. Carol Bruce sang it in the 1941 musical comedy Keep 'Em Flying, starring Abbott and Costello. All right, so we had, on trumpet, Colton. And the title, I'm Getting Sentimental Over You. Yes, so another 10 points. Well, we're knocking off these, so you should be getting more points as we get through here. All right, I just left my clues on this page. The next tune, made famous in 1964, by the Count Basie Orchestra. And this arrangement we're going to play for you tonight is the exact same arrangement. We were able to get hold of that. So we're going to share this next one. Count Basie, 1964. On trombone, Friedrich. Also on trombone, Ashley. And on piano, Garen.
Hey, that's my roommate!
All right, the next one. Another one from 2019. Oh, I gotta tell you this one, don't I? Oh, man. Which one was this? Oh, Sol Mio, yes. So if you got that, put it down. If not, that's okay. It's okay. Now the next one, 2019. I'm excited about this one. I jumped to it early. It means a spicy food dish. It represents, I threw you off there for a minute, represents a spicy food dish. right, soloist, Garen on piano. Cole on trumpet. Luke on tenor.
Oh, what a man!
And Wes on alto. All right, the next tune was written in 1951. I keep forgetting to do that. I'm just jumping ahead. What was that piece? Mofongo de Mama. Yes. Mofongo is a spicy dish, and it's Mama's dish. So we don't mess with Mama's dish. All right, now the next tune. Thank you for keeping me honest. Now, if you're just as honest with your points, we'll be good. The next tune, 1951. It was a hit actually twice for the same person. The second time it was a hit, it was with a father and daughter duet produced after he had died.
Thank you.
So we had on trumpet, Cole. Tenor sax, Luke. And the name of that tune? Unforgettable. There we go. To be 100% honest, I was supposed to sing that, but I figured you'd enjoy it much better on trumpet. All right, we're coming close. We're narrowing down the tunes here. The next tune is from 2018, and it was featured in the movie The Incredibles 2. All right, Colton on trumpet. Yeah. Friedrich on trombone. And Wes on flute. Did you notice I almost forgot to get the mic to him? Like, I'm liking this piece. All right, the name of it is? Digging the Digs. So some of you are going, oh, I didn't get that one, but at least now you have another one off your list. I'm going to give extra credit. What meter is that in? He was going, meter? What's the time signature? 5-4. 3-4. It's a waltz. 3-4. It's a waltz. So some of you may have got 10 extra points with that. Most of you need to join Dr. Wood's theory class. Fundamentals. All right, the next piece, written in 1964. Now this is, if you miss, it's a negative 10 points. So you either get plus 10 or negative. Written in 1964, originally written for a trio, piano, bass, and drums, and it was featured in a TV special. Had on piano, Garen. Alto sax, Wes. And on trumpet, Colton. And the piece was, I'm back on, Linus and Lucy. And the first first special it was on was the Christmas special, the Charlie Brown Christmas. Yes. So that's an extra no points. All right, so we're narrowing it down. There's not too many left for you to choose from which to choose. So, next one. It was originally written in 1972, but the famous version of it was in 1976. This recording in 76 won a Grammy Award for the Record of the Year, and it was also nominated for Song of the Year and Best Pop Vocal Performance, Male. We're going to bring Ashley back up to share with you this next tune.
looking for words to say. Searching but not finding, understanding anyway. We're lost in this masquerade. Both afraid to say we're just too far away from being close together from the start. We tried to talk it over, but the words got in the way. We're lost inside this lonely game we play. Brothers and no matter how hard I try to find the reason that we carry on this way, we're lost. Not finding, understanding anyway. No matter how hard I try to understand the reason that we carry on this way, we'll love.
And the title is? It's Masquerade. Good, you were listening. That's good to hear. All right, now this is 50-50 right here. Last two. This one was released in 1965, and the album was the same name as the title of the song. No concert is complete without this particular individual, so we will share with you now. See if you can hear it. And the title? I got you. By whom? James Brown. All right. Yeah, that was just me. So, solos, we had Wes on alto sax. And Luke on tenor. All right, now I'm going to give you the last one as 10 points. So hopefully you get that one right. But I've got another bonus for you. In the 30s and 40s, one big band leader always wore white tails to his performances. That's for 20 points if you can name the big band leader who always wore white tails, white vest to his concert. Cab Calloway is correct. So if you got Cab Calloway, don't cheat. 20 points there. So it was my homage to Cab Calloway. So let's count up your points. Figure out your points. It's prize time. How many of you had over 100 points? 100 points. Wow, not bad. 110. 130. 140, 150. Wow, all right, so here are your prizes. First, you get free tickets to the next 5 concerts. You laugh, that's an expensive deal. Our next concert is tomorrow night, 6:30. And they get free cookies tonight. Everybody who came and played the game gets free cookies. But tomorrow night at 6:30 in the Smart Building on the square, the jazz band will be playing from 6:30 to 7:15. If you're expecting new music, come and listen to this. You'll have a good time. So we're excited about that. Tomorrow night, we have the choir concert in here at 7:30. And then I keep losing that. We've got the football game where the marching band is going to be doing a great show called The Superhero World. With actors and actresses and all kinds of things. You'll love that show. That's at 1 o'clock. Then Sunday, we close out homecoming with the concert band doing its tribute to classical band music. Every piece of music that we'll be playing has been played here at Greenville College or Greenville University. It's been here. We're celebrating the 115th anniversary of the concert band here at Greenville. So that's an exciting event. We have some special guests. The band director who was here first year for the 50th anniversary, we'll be back to conduct one of the pieces. One of the pieces he conducted that first year. So Dr. Everett Sanders will be conducting, 90 years old, and he'll be conducting, so 3 o'clock on Sunday. All right, so the other prizes are, if you had over 130, hands one more time, if you had over 130, you get to donate and write a check to the jazz band for $1,000. You get to help us out. Those who had 100 to 130, who are you? People are erasing the scratching. That's $500 you can write a check to donate to the jazz band program. We hope you've enjoyed this evening. We've had a great time presenting this music to you. We're going to close with a tune from 2010. It's our signature tune. We play at just about every concert for the last few years. I'm not going to tell you the title. Thank you for being here. We hope you have a great, great homecoming time. Reconnect with folks, professors, fellow students. Enjoy the time. There's so many things going on. I just listed a few that pertain to my students here. But there are so many more things to do this weekend, and we're glad you're here. We're glad you're here to celebrate. So we close now. Thank you for being here. Come get cookies across the way. Really? On tenor sax, Luke. On trombone, Ashley. Cole on trumpet. Wes on flute. And Noah on the set. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. See you over for cookies.